Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. Today I'm walking you through how to create these really neat looking color splash photos like these right here using Adobe Express. It's a great creative way to add some color to your photo. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I'm at the home screen of Adobe Express and I'll start by dragging in the image that I'm going to be using to create this color splash. So let's go ahead and drag it in from the desktop and you'll see here, start from your content. And that is the picture that I'm going to be using for this example. I'll choose create new and I'll use the original aspect ratio. You can also click the blue button to import an image, but I like doing the drag in here. All right, so I've got the image here. We're gonna go ahead and make sure that it's not locked to the background. If for some reason your image is locked to the background, you wanna make sure and uncheck right here where it says detach page background. That way you're able to move that image freely on your canvas here. So let's go ahead and bring that back. So now what I'm going to do is duplicate this image. I've got it set up within the canvas. This is a Instagram reel or story size frame here. So I'm gonna go ahead and duplicate the image. So right here in the image menu, we see the option to duplicate. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. And since I already got it sized up, we're gonna go ahead and just drag it and we'll line it up. We'll use our guideline right there to make sure it is lined up evenly. All right, and then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to do something with the image in the back. We're going to do something first is we're going to bring down the opacity on that top layer. The important thing, you want to make sure that the top layer, which you see over here on the right, is selected. And you can see right here it is not there. What I should say, we cannot see it, it is there, but the opacity has been brought down. Then what we'll do is select the bottom layer. And you can see over here, the opacity of that bottom layer is 100%. You wanna make sure that that is the one selected. And what we're going to do now is come down to the adjustment layer here. And we're gonna use some of these Photoshop powered features here in Adobe Express. We're going to bring down that saturation. We're gonna make this a black and white image. And we're also going to play a little bit with the lighting here. We're gonna bring that lighting up and let's go ahead maybe and bring some of that brightness up. There we go. And let's check out the contrast. See if we go too much or too little. Yeah, I like a little bit contrast there. Perfect. And let's see brightness. I think that works just fine. And now what we're going to do is come back over to the top layer here and we can see our opacity is zero. We're going to bring that up. And now here's what we're going to do is we are going to use the remove background feature here because we want to isolate that art piece. By the way, this is in San Antonio. I'm going to go ahead and remove that background. Now, this is going to be a little bit tricky here because it doesn't always remove everything. For example, right here, we have this building here. And what we're going to do is use the erase function up here. And we're going to make sure that the circle brush is selected and not the quick selection there. So circle brush, and we can fine tune the size of that circle brush. So what we'll do is we will make it as large as we can without erasing some of that red. There we go. We're going to do this and get as close as I can without getting too close to some of that red. And what I'm going to do is click done here just for a second. I'm going to click out here and just to kind of take a quick look, and I'm going to use the command plus sign that gives me close in here, and I'm going about 150. And here's like a really cool tip is hold down the space bar and then you can move this, center that. So we want to do that so I can see this section here, and then again click on the image and then we'll go to erase once more. And now we're going to bring down that size maybe a little bit more so I can get into this little bush right here. Bring it down just a bit because I see that it's going a little bit into that red. Here we go. And this is not going to be 100% perfect, but close enough. We're going to take some of this down right here. I'm not too worried about that section here, but I do want to get rid of some of this color over here of that building. Maybe go a little bit bigger here. So this is going to vary. This will vary on your images. Some of them will do a nice job of removing the background and you don't have to do a lot of this erasing. Some of them you might have to do a little bit more tweaking like I am doing here. And I think that is pretty good. I'm liking the way that looks. I don't see any color in between here. And I'm going to click done. And then I'm going to go to the zoom option here. And let's go fit to selection. I should say fit to all. And perfect. Now, what I think I'm going to do here is I'm going to use my command all because I want to center that red art piece. Now, the reason I select all so I can get the back image and the front image, and that'll make sure that I have that centered, and then I can drag this. So now it's centered. You can see some of this is the image that's bleeding out, and that's okay because I want my art piece to be centered. Perfect. And then I will do a little bit more adjusting. I'll go back to the adjustments here, and let's see the shadows. Maybe bring down the shadows and then maybe do something to the red. We'll go into the adjustment, maybe bump up the saturation of that. Ooh, look at that. That looks beautiful. I like that. Really make that red pop. And that's how to create color splash images using Adobe Express. So now it's your turn to give it a try. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and if you enjoyed this video, click the bell to be notified to see new videos just like this one. And please do share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video. And as always, have fun creating. Peace.